Hey guys, I'm back and today I have created a new video with a new concept. So today I'm going to talk about how to do flatlay. So here's the first episode. So the first and important step is choosing the background. Depending on the concept and frame, you need to choose it. I prefer to use a monotonous shade, either a pure white or jet black or a peach undertone. So here it is, I'm using a marble slab for this video. So the second most important thing is concept. While you are taking a flatlay, when the viewer will see, you must represent some idea or concept. Now I had no idea while I was shooting this video, so I tried to keep it a basic one. Therefore I used all the basic things that we require in our daily life. So first I started with a storybook. Normally when I go for a storybook, I prefer an old one with tinted pages. So here it is. So when I started using the book, a lot of other things came into my mind, what I use in our daily life. So here it's a cup of tea. I intentionally used a black tea cup just to bring out a contrast. So normally when I do a flatlay or a photoshoot, which is a vintage concept, I prefer to use a rose gold watch. Here you can see some quick add-ons. I have tried to use some junk jewelry which will pop out and give a rose gold effect, and I have used some notes and book as well. And here comes the last add-ons. You can see already I have placed the marble coasters up right there, and here comes some flowers. So the flowers. We all know flowers make the frame look more aesthetic, but you must keep in mind the size of the flowers should be really small or else they would grab the attention. Rather steal the attention, and people would avoid or ignore the other accessories in the frame. And the color of the flower should be kept in mind depending upon the concept. Because I'm gonna give a vintage edit, the color of the flower should pop out. That's why I have chosen violet. Now, no matter how perfect your frame is, it can get ruined unless you have a good lighting. As you can see, it was not a sunny day, so I wasn't getting a proper or a good lighting. And the left side of my frame was under shadows. Therefore, I requested my mother to hold the ring light, and I used a yellow shade just to have a perfect lighting. So here you can see. After you have thought about the concept, taking the perfect accessories, made your lighting just superb, the basic idea while having the photo should be, what should be the size of your frame? Now normally I upload my flatlays on Instagram, so it's very obvious I can't take a rectangular frame or choose a rectangular frame. I need to have a square frame, and for that I just can't keep the things here and there, like keep space between them. I need to tack them down, pull them closer. So here it is, I'm deciding how to bring them together and not make it look tacky. So while taking the photos, you must decide an angle from where it looks perfect. So this is not a 90 degree, this is probably a 70 to 80 degree. Even this is not a 90 degree, but it's really close to it. So after clicking a lot of photos, I finally decided to go with this one, but remember I have to crop it. So after thinking about a while choosing the perfect picture, I gave this a vintage edit. You may not like it or think it over the board, but that's how I do it. So I really thought of adding the squared version of photo in this video. However, I was unable to do it due to the settings of this video. So this is how it looks. And excuse the part, because in editing I use a lot of greens. However, apart from that, if you like this video, hit the thumbs up. I will be back with more. More new ideas and concepts will be coming up in the next few episodes. Stay tuned with my Insta handle Shreliasta. Till then, bye and take care.